-5, -4, -3, -2, -1, 0. Sorry, guys. I was counting backwards, and it's taking me a little while, so thanks for waiting. Counting backwards from where? Well, I counted all the way backwards from infinity. From infinity, yes. It's crazy, I know. But I did it. It's the first time I ever did it. I don't know if I'll do it again. I might try it again tomorrow, but that took a long, long time. So I now know I can do it. Now, obviously, you know, that's impossible. You can't count backwards from infinity because there's no place to start from, because wherever you start from, you still have an infinity to go back further. And so this is the idea behind what is called the Kalam cosmological argument for the existence of God. Don't worry about the name. It's not that big of a deal. But here's the basic idea, is that there has to be a beginning. If there is a now, see, I got to zero, right? That's now. If there is a now, we're standing here right now, we're talking right now, I'm discussing this right now. If there is a now, and I believe that there is a now, that's pretty obvious, then there has to be a beginning, because otherwise you would always have an infinite amount of succession of movements, moments, changes, one right after the other, in order to get to the now. And there's no way to have an infinite succession of anything going before you. Therefore, if we are in the now, there is a beginning. There is a start to all things. There's a start to time. There's a start to movement, space and matter moving. And therefore, there is a creation of all things. There is a beginning of all things. This goes against any type of argument that basically argues for a steady state universe. This idea that whatever it is that's happened before us, whatever the universe was like, whatever, you know, up to the Big Bang or before the Big Bang, whatever it is, it's always been. Time has always happened. There was not a beginning of all things. But the problem is, again, that would be counting backwards to zero now from infinity. There has to be a beginning. You cannot have an infinite succession of moments, of movements going in the negative direction. It's kind of like saying, if a man were to jump out of an infinitely deep hole, when would he get out? He'd say never. Well, because he never has a place to start from. Getting out of the hole is the now. We're here. So therefore, something, there was a beginning of that hole. There was a start. So think of it this way. Basic argument for the existence of God is the existence of the beginning of all things. If there was a beginning, there has to be something transcendent outside of time that is not caught up in this loop that we're talking about that started it all. Otherwise, we would have to explain that which began it all in the succession of time before that individual, that person, that God, whatever it is. Therefore, there has to be a transcendent God, a God that is above space, time, matter, that created all of these things out of nothing at some time in the finite past. So, what does this argument basically say? It says, if there is a now, then there is a God.